Our text is in John chapter 8, verse 12. Then John chapter 9, verse 5. And Matthew chapter 5, verse 14 to 15. The title is The Satellite. We know what is satellite. The one that borrows only light from the sun. Satellite. In John chapter 8, verse 12, it says, when Jesus spoke again to the people, he said, I am the light of the world. Whoever follows me will never walk in darkness, but will have the light of life. He goes again and said, in John chapter 9, verse 5, he says, while I am in the world, I am the light of the world. So when Jesus was in the world, when he was in the world teaching, he says, I am the light of the world. Now that Jesus is not anymore the world, he is sitting in the right hand of his Father. He gave us the authority. He said in Matthew chapter 5, verse 14, you are the light of the world. A city located on a hill cannot be hidden. People don't light a lamp and put it under a basket, but a lampstand. And it gives light to everyone in the house. In the same way, let your light to shine before men, before people, in such a way that you will see your good work, good actions, and glorify your Father in heaven. In verse 1 of chapter 5, he go up to the mountain. When he saw the crowd, he go up to the mountain and sit. Some scholars, when Jesus said that when Jesus is sitting, he has an important things to teach to his disciples. His disciples, maybe it's not only the 12, but many, or because he said the crowd. So we know what is disciple means. What is disciple means? A learner. All the people that wants to learn about the teaching of Jesus Christ are disciples. So he is charging us to be the light. This one with Jesus, he go up to the mountainside teaching them. He teach them about the Beatitudes. In chapter 5, he teach about the Beatitudes. Then he go on and go on, and then he charge us, who will give us an authority to be the light of the world. Why are the citizens of the kingdom is as the light of the world? From the time we accepted Jesus Christ as Lord and Savior, we are light of the world. It says, because light is a special type of deity. God is light, signifying that God is the source of purity, beauty, joy, and glory. In the strictest sense, Christ Himself is the light of the world. Remember, when God created the heaven and earth, it was darkness. First thing, He said in Genesis chapter 1, verse 3, go memorize that. I know some of the children knows that verse. And God said, let there be light, and there was light, so there was light. That's how important light in the creation. He made first the light. So we are Christ's satellites. If you are Christ's satellites, by walk and virtue of the recipient relationship to Him, we hold forth the Christly light, reflect it, and shed it on men. As the moon or the stars reflect the light of the sun, the followers of Christ reflect the light. So we are the reflector. We can see, or people could see us, that we are the light. Like the sun, as I've said, it reflects the moon and the stars borrow lights from the sun. This passage teaches us that the Christian light, the Christian's light, is derived from Christ. Number two, the Christian light is reflector. It's like the reflector, the satellite. Christian life reflects the excellent model and Savior of the world. Christ shines through His people. The Christians is the light diffuser. We know what is diffuser. Yung tagakalat ng balita. Siya yung nagparami, nag-spread. He's the one who spread the gospel. We, the Christian, is the light, the diffuser. This is the one that God has given us the authority or charging us. When He say, you are the light of the world. Jesus gives the Christian both a great compliment and a great responsibility when He says, you are the light of the world, because He claimed the title for Himself as He walked on earth. So, we have a great responsibility, because Jesus Christ Himself claim that He is the light of the world. Now that Jesus ascended in heaven, we are church, or we have given an authority to light the earth. He said, light the lamp. Every one of us should have a lamp, or rather be a lamp, to shine out the darkness of the world. Let your light to shine before men. The purpose of light is to illuminate and expose what is there. You know, the purpose of light is to illuminate. Therefore, light must be exposed before it is of any use. If it is hidden under a basket, it's no longer useful. So we have a moral obligations in force herein. When they say, let your light shine, the word implies that the effort is necessary to develop the proper influence of the Christian character. We should have an effort to influence the non-believer, either from ones of moral courage, or ones of fidelity to truth and profession, or spiritual indifference. We may hide our light under a basket. This is our church, the church. Jesus charged us, or giving us. Number one is shine. It says that which does not shine is not light. Are you agree with that? Kung hindi ka lumiliwanag, hindi ka ilaw. Number two, obligations. We should shine brightly. The word chosen, the light of some of the stars is not large in volume, yet very bright. It is not the largeness of our endowments we have to consider, but the transparent radiance of our life. Therefore, should be nothing in us to hinder that light. In Christian perfection of character that shines brightly, there must be seven prismatic colors, all the beatitudes, which compose of pure ray of Christly light. Next moral obligation is shine conspicuously, like a city is set on a hill. Like this, a city set on a hill. It can be seen by all people. It's not hidden. Tagalog pa, huwag yung maandap-andap. Ang ilaw mo.
Hindi Tagalog.
Shine constantly. Faithful Christian, you know what is faithful Christian? Ito yung nabubuo kami tao. Mga Kristiyano. A faithful Christian do very little good. It is not the blessing comet or the wandering stars that guides the mariner, but the fixed star. I know we have here a mariner. Anong palatandaan nyo? Direction. The satellite. The fixed star. It's not the wandering star or the comet that. So the one that guides the mariner is the fixed star. It shines constantly. Number five, shine usefully. Neither do men light a candle and put it under a basket. We do not light a candle in an open day or in twilight. And then put it out when it is dark. Though in religion, this kind of thing is frequently done in the presence of the Lord. Sometimes, pakitang tao. When I share in sunrise, I meet a white guy, a Canadian guy, said, when I'm giving, and sharing to him. He said, no, most of the church goers are hypocrites. He said that to me. Why? Because when they are in the church, you know, how kind they are. But when they are in their home or in anywhere, they are not kind anymore. That's why most of the churchgoers are hypocrites. To us, in house of prayer and in church, we should shine brightly. Cannot be hidden. Means that just like a city that is set on hill, it goes against the very nature and purpose of life. It's not to be hidden. When a Christian hides his life, what happened? He fights himself and the Holy Spirit by never letting his light to shine before men. So if he hides, we fight. Not to let the Holy Spirit lights on us. Put it in a lampstand. So when we have the light, although here we're not anymore using this one, in the province where there's no light, we put it the light on the lampstand. The purpose is to the higher because so that it will be more effective. We should look for ways to let the light shine in a greater and broader way. That's the purpose it on the lampstand. Anyway, most of the children now don't experience the lamp or the candle that is put in the lampstand. The purpose of it, so that the light will shine. That they may see your good works. If hidden, they will not see your good works. And glorify your Father in heaven. The purpose in letting our light so shine by doing good works is so that others will glorify God, not ourselves. Sometimes we want to shine just to glorify ourselves, but the purpose is to glorify God, it's not ourselves. If we shine, that is from God. He's the one that gives us the light. On doing good. If it is true that charity begins at home, I am quite sure that it is still more true that the kingdom of God on which we are earnestly caring will begin in our hearts. In the practical holiness which costs us more self-denial than seemingly the zealous efforts men work for as they seek to save the souls of others. I wonder why. To the young people, I have a question. If your parents are not Christians, and you are the only Christians, how will you bring your light to your parents? And to the husband and wife also. For example, the husband or the wife or either, one of you is not a Christian. Can you bring this light to your husband or to your wife? Can DBC your light in you? So I have heard a joke. Two men walking in the sunshine afternoon. One said, "Oh, that's looking at the sky." He said, "Oh, that's a moon." The other said, "No, that's a sun." They are arguing. "Oh, that's a sun. That's a moon." They say that's a moon. So they argue together. Then they see a house. Then they said, "We will go to that house. Who is right between you and me?" Then they ring about the bell on the house. Then man came out and said, "Oh, what can I do to you? So we want you to judge us, who is right. Is it in the sky is the sun or the moon?" He answered, "No, I wouldn't answer you because I am 2 weeks on this place." So sometimes we do not know why or what we are. So why this throat needed today? Because Christians are not aware of this throat. We are really not aware of, sometimes Christians are not aware of this truth, that we are the light of the world. Now there are four things necessary for the lamps giving light properly. It must be, number one is lighted. When it is lighted by another, cannot be lighted by itself any more than it can be. It can make itself, only God lights us. In Hebrew, he said, in Hebrew 10:25, we must not quit meeting together, as some are doing. No, we need to keep encouraging each other. This becomes more and more important as you see the day getting closer. So lighting together, encouraging together, so that our light will shine more brightly. Not, he said, the Hebrew said, the writer of Hebrew said, we must not quit meeting together as some are doing. Hindi aandap-andap tayo if we are always here in the house of prayer like church. As light of the world, our modes of assembling are mainly of three things when we are always here. As Hebrews 10:25 said, we assemble together for the purpose of Christian fellowship. We assemble together for the purpose of worship and instruction. And we assemble together to remember the Lord's death with the help of his appointed emblems. Number two, sit not under the basel. Hindi tatakpan, no? Prominent place. Sheltered or may not be blown out. Sit so as to shine for useful purposes. So, hindi talaga pwedeng nakatago ka kung hindi nakalandag ka lalo. We have to sit the light for a useful purposes. Christian life, like the light, is active. Light, like heat or sound, is not a substance, but a mere motion. The waves of light are very small, but their motion is inconceivably rapid. There's a motion. You feel it continually, day by day. With proper oil, in proper way. Only God has the oil of grace, the Holy Spirit, to keep the light burning. We have, last month, we have the daily office. Emotionally healthy spirituality. We have the daily office. We read the Bible every day. We pray every day. So we feed it. During when I was young, we really use the oil or the gas, because in our province until now we don't have electricity, so we have to use with proper oil so that we feed in to the Holy Spirit or the Bible. We read it every day, so that feeding is continually be on that lamp. Number four is we train it. Cutting off what would hinder the brightness of the flame. If you are living like in our province, you have to trim the
thread
that would hinder the what we call the
wicks.
Yeah. So we have to trim that one so that it will. The light will come brightly. So cutting off that would hinder the brightness of the lamp, careful trimming, and constant feeding needful to bright shine. So I hope that it is clearer to us now that we Christians are the light of the world, whether we like it or not. Christ, Jesus charged us to shine wherever we go. Remember, he says, I will be with you wherever you are, even to the ends of the world. So we are the light of the world. We hope that we shine brightly. You know, people around us, especially those unbelievers, are trying to see what our faults. See, are you a Christian? Why you are like that? Why you are doing which is not good in the sight of men? As if you are not shining. God reminds us that we are the light of the world. He wants us to shine in darkness. In our workplace, God wants us to shine. In our friends, God wants us to shine. I hope that we bear in mind that all of us here are light of the world. Shall we pray? Our loving Heavenly Father, once again, thank you for the dear God this whole time. Thank you for reminding us that we are the light of the world. That you want us to shine, O God. You want us, O Lord, that all men would say we see our good works, so that our Father in heaven would be glorified, not ourselves only. Thank you, O God, in Jesus Christ our Lord.